Anger, Part 26.
Jai Sachidanand.
I bow down to the absolute pure soul within all of you, with utmost devotion and oneness. My salutations, salutations, salutations.
Jai Sachidanand.
Did you all do Samayik yesterday? Let us study Dada's talks further.
Jai Sachidanand, page number 27, heading, This is Beastliness of a Kind. Questioner, if we end up getting angry and cursing at someone, then how can we correct that? Dadashri, as it is, you end up getting angry and cursing at others because you do not have control of your own self. In order to maintain control, you first need to understand something. You should examine whether or not you are able to bear it when someone gets angry with you. Before you get angry, you should examine, if someone gets angry with me, then am I able to bear it? Do I like it or not? The way you like to be treated, you should behave in the same way with others.
We should behave with others in the same way that we would like to be treated. Only if I can remember that, he says. Do we like it if someone pressures us, or if someone gets angry or irritated? If such awakened awareness prevails, then it is considered a very big awareness. Humanity starts from this level. Anything below this is all considered beastliness. I don't care what happens to the other person. I enjoyed it. I got my way, and I'm happy. Therefore, the understanding is missing. We've never thought about this in our lives, that such kinds of mistakes exist. Dada revealed all this, and that's why we're able to study it, and we have started observing this in our own self. Oh, I didn't realize that the other person is getting hurt. As we do pratikraman, the awakened awareness will arise. Sooner or later, we will understand that this mistake is mine. As we keep doing pratikraman for that, the understanding will keep increasing. Read on. Here at every level, we should feel, if someone gets angry at me, then will I be able to bear it? Do I like it? This should be there in each and every matter. If someone insults me, then would I like it? So we should have the awakened awareness before insulting anyone. It applies even to the thoughts of sexuality. If someone looks at me with a sexual intent like this, then would I like it? Then I should not look at anyone with a sexual intent. If someone misuses my money, then would I like it? Then I should not misuse anyone's money. If someone betrays me, then would I like it? So I should not betray anyone. We should think like this in all matters. If someone scorns us, or if some unwanted guests arrive at an untimely hour, we feel, why did they come at this time? What if someone thinks like this about me? Therefore, I should not do this. What level is referred to as unhappiness? It is the one that we ourselves don't like. At least we should stop at that level while interacting with others. That would be a very big start. There's a lot more than this ahead. Read on.
So, if the person curses at you, and that does not bother you or does not depress you, then you can do so. Otherwise, you should indeed put a stop to it.
If the other person speaks such words to us, then would we like it? No, we would not. So then we should stop doing it to others.
You should never curse at people. This is actually beastliness of a kind. Underdeveloped people. Beastliness of a kind. Uncultured.
Dada says, underdeveloped people. Beastliness of a kind. Uncultured. Dada would never use such words. However, to dissect the disease, Dada would use such words so that his disease would be eradicated. It's referred to as a kind of beastliness. Beastliness means the snake catches the frog. The frog keeps squirming in pain. It almost dies, but the snake doesn't let it go. When it dies, the snake eats it. The snake eats the entire body, so the ego is included in it. Whereas here, the strong ego eats the weak ego, and it's referred to as beastliness. We should protect the weak and should not hurt them. Instead, we hurt the weak, no matter what happens to him. The intellect is of that kind. There's this much difference between the heart and the intellect. What does the intellect do? It crushes the other person for its own happiness. Whereas the heart thinks about the collective happiness. The other person will feel the same pain as me. I don't want to hurt him. How can everyone benefit? People say this person's heart has completely stopped. Therefore, even if the other person is getting crushed, he doesn't have the awareness. This is referred to as beastliness. In the animal realm, this kind of nature prevails, as in the leopard kills the deer. Now, they have nothing to do with each other. The deer has not bound any vengeance with the leopard. However, if the leopard's hungry, it'll kill the deer. The lions and lionesses will kill the buffaloes if they're alone. Bigger living beings keep on killing smaller beings. This is the law of the universe. Similarly, the strong ego keeps crushing the weak ego. When the weak ego is crushed, then the second part of nature is that the weak ego makes a firm resolve, I won't spare you. His energy keeps increasing, whereas the strong ego has committed a crime, an offense, and that's why he'll become weak. So the one with a strong ego becomes weak because he is bound demerit karma. That's why he becomes weak. Whereas the one with a weak ego becomes strong. He earns merit karma. So the deer earns merit karma, the buffalo also earn merit karma and go into a higher life form, whereas the one with the strong ego had more merit karma, so some of it gets used up. He goes lower. In this way, everyone keeps growing through the pluses and minuses of nature. Read on.
Page 28, heading, Pratikaman is indeed the true path to liberation. In the past, people were taught to maintain kindness, peace, equanimity, forgiveness. Whereas these people say, hey, I keep getting angry and you are telling me to maintain forgiveness? But how am I to maintain forgiveness?
The preachings in religion are, hey, you should not engage in corruption. You should not lie. You should not steal. You're telling me not to do so. What can I do if it keeps on happening? Here it says, I keep getting angry, and you're telling me to maintain forgiveness. To maintain forgiveness means if someone instigates us, then we should forgive him. I forgive you, I will not take revenge on you. But I'm the one feeling instigated. Here he says, but how am I to maintain forgiveness? Read on.
Therefore, they should actually be taught in this way. If you end up getting angry, then you should repent within like this. What kind of weakness lies in me that I end up getting angry like this? I have done wrong. Repent in this way, and if you have a guru above you, then take his help and make a firm determination that this weakness does not arise again.
This is such a tremendous discovery of Dadas. It was correct in Satyug, the era of the time cycle that is characterized by unity in thoughts, speech, and action. This is because they had already come to 300 miles. And so they were told, if you don't do this, then you'll be able to progress further. Whereas now, he may be standing at 700 miles. So he keeps clearing the anger. He keeps decreasing the anger, pride, deceit, greed, and he will reach this station. Then the station of forgiveness that is natural and spontaneous will come later. So the preachings for the one who is at 700 miles are different. If you end up getting angry, then repent for it in your mind in this manner. What kind of weakness lies in me that I end up getting angry? What I did was wrong. I ended up hurting the other person by getting angry. I heartily repent for that. Please forgive me. If you have a guru or whichever god you believe in, keep him as a witness and repent for all your faults. Then that person who is at 700 miles will come to 500 miles. When he reaches 300 miles, then all these talks will be applicable for him at 300 miles. Dada did the same in the matter of celibacy. He said, there's no point in controlling, just turn back. People look at others with the sexual intent, spoil their thoughts and their conduct. If one is saved from all of these offenses, then he will earn a lot. Therefore, Dada showed us the path of minimum loss. Dada says, forget the profit, decrease the loss. It's the same in the matters of worship. If we don't speak in a manner that is contrary to facts about a person leading to spiritual descent, then it's referred to as worship. If we don't hurt the other person, then that's equivalent to giving him happiness. If we can't give happiness, then there's no problem, but don't hurt others. Therefore, don't hurt anyone. It's okay if you cannot give happiness, but at least decrease the loss. If you cannot earn profit, then there's no problem. Stop incurring a loss. Read on.
Do not defend your anger from now on. On the contrary, do pratikaman for it. So make a note of how many times in a day you have hurt another living being through thought, speech, or action, atikarman, and with whom it happened, and do pratikaman at that time.
He's showing us a way. How many atikramans happened in a day? With whom did they happen? We should take a note of that. Now, we should take a note of our own faults. Instead, the camera is on others. What mistake did the other person make? How did he make the mistake? How to straighten him up? Our focus of the camera should not be like that. We should make a note of our own prakriti. How many atikramans did I do? With whom did they happen? What was my fault in that? If our vision towards seeing our own faults develops, then we will be able to do real pratikraman. If one accepts his own fault as a fault, only then will the real pratikraman start. As long as one feels that it is the fault of the other person, he won't be able to do real pratikraman for his own faults. If we do real pratikraman, then that fault will keep decreasing, and we can experience that we are getting free from that.
What should you do in pratikraman? If you got angry and the other person got hurt, then recall the soul of the other person and ask for forgiveness. So ask for forgiveness for what happened. Take a vow that you will not do it again. And alochana means to confess the mistake to me, as in, I have committed this mistake.
Basically, Dada has shown an easy way for those who have not taken Gnan. Whichever God he believes in, or he can recall Dada Bhagwan, I ended up making this mistake, I heartily repent for that, I ask for forgiveness. That is pratikraman, and vow not to repeat that mistake again. These three should be together. If we keep saying, I made a mistake, then that's wrong. If one keeps saying, I feel a lot of repentance, even that is wrong. It'll remain incomplete. If we see the other person as flawless and accept our own fault, then we'll be able to do true pratikraman. Read on.
Heading, ask for forgiveness even from within. Questioner, Dada, when I repent or do pratikraman, then many times it so happens that when I have made a mistake or I've ended up getting angry with someone, then I feel the inner burning within that this is wrong. Yet I do not have the courage to ask the other person for forgiveness.
Right, we do not have the courage to ask for forgiveness in person. We feel a lot of repentance in our mind.
Dadashri, nor should you make such an apology. Page 29. Otherwise, the other person might misuse it. The other person may think, yes, now you have come to your senses, haven't you? This is the way it is.
Dada says, nor should you make such an apology. If you ask for forgiveness personally every time, then people will misuse it. They'll say, yes, now you've come to your senses, haven't you? Therefore, don't ask for forgiveness in this way. Dada says these are not noble people.
These are not noble people. These people are not such that you can ask for forgiveness in person. So you should just ask for forgiveness from within, by recalling the pure soul of the other person. Out of 1,000 people, there might be only 10 who are such that they will bow down even more than you, even before you ask for forgiveness.
We should check where we stand amongst them. If the other person asks for forgiveness, even then, we keep getting irritated at him. You don't improve, and you're asking for forgiveness? Is that what you've learned? You harass me every day. So isn't it understood that we're amongst those thousands? We have not come in those 10. Truly, we should come in those 10. We should have such nobility. If the other person bows down an inch, we should bow down a foot. Hey, why are you asking for forgiveness? No. You haven't made any mistake. I didn't even feel that. Please don't take any burden. So he bows before the other person that asks for forgiveness. Whereas here, if the other person bows down to ask for forgiveness, then he'll hit him on his head. He'll say, You haven't improved. You need to improve. Learn how to do things. That's not considered nobility. Read on.
Heading: A result like instant cash by doing pratikaman heartily. Questioner: Say I get infuriated with someone and after retorting, I become quiet. Thereafter, because I spoke out, I feel even more burning within. In such a case, do I need to do pratikaman more than once?
What is he saying? He says, I get infuriated with someone and after retorting, I become quiet. After we end up saying it, we feel inner burning within. I made such a big mistake. Now, how many pratikarmans do I need to do? Dada explains very nicely.
Dadashi, if you do it 2 to 3 times, pouring your heart into it, and if it is done very precisely, then it is finished. Oh, Dada Bhagwan, I got extremely angry. The other person was so hurt by it. I ask for forgiveness for that. I am heartily asking for forgiveness in your presence.
Do pratikarman 2 to 3 times heartily, very heartily. If you do it for 2 to 3 times, then that's more than enough. With Dada Bhagwan as my witness, I ended up making this huge mistake. I ask for forgiveness. Then it's more than enough. What happens is, we keep getting confused for hours at a time by finding faults of others, and then we get confused in the repentance as well for hours at a time. In that suffering, one goes into depression. We don't want that to happen. We should say, Oh Dada Bhagwan, I ended up making this mistake. I ask for forgiveness for that. Give me the strength not to repeat this mistake again. You should do this 3 or 4 times nicely and then stop. However, if it's a very sticky file, then lots of faults happen with that person. When one sees that person, then 25 types of faults arise. He did this the other day. He's like this. He's like that. We should repent for each one of them and wash it off. We should do this for each matter every time. Then the stickiness with that file will keep decreasing. Read on. It's coming up next.
Heading: The fault is also non-living. Questioner: The fury that arises due to atikraman cools down through pratikaman. Dadashri: Yes, it cools down. If it is a sticky file, then 5,000 pratikaman have to be done. Only then will it cool down.
If it's a sticky file, then 5,000 pratikarmans have to be done. This is for sticky files. Don't do it all in one day, okay? You should do it gradually. Mainly what he's trying to say is the stickiness. What Dada is trying to say is that this person is my sticky file. However, it's not the fault of the other person. It's the fault of our stickiness. We've done a lot of multiplications, and that's why such stickiness has arisen. If we wash out our stickiness, then we will become free from the relationship with the other person.
If the anger was not exhibited externally, but you got irritated from within, even then, if you do not do pratikaman for that, then that much stain will remain with you. If you do pratikaman, then it will get cleared off. If you have done atikraman, then do pratikaman.
We did not get angry on the outside, but got irritated within. That means on the outside, the other person did not come to know. However, we got irritated within. Even then, we need to do pratikarma for that. If we don't do so, then the stain will remain on us. If we do pratikarma, then it'll get cleared. Therefore, there are two kinds of pratikarma. One is when one hurts the other person by getting angry. What happens with sticky files? It's very less on the outside, but we keep getting irritated within. We see that person and have negativity towards him. We see him and we feel negativity towards him. Dada says, then that much stain will remain with you. We surely need to wash those off as well. Read on.
Page 30. Questioner: After getting angry with someone, if I realize it and I ask for forgiveness for that person at that very moment, then what is that considered?
If we ask for forgiveness at that very moment, then what is that considered?
Dadashri: After attaining this jnan, knowledge of the self, and the doer attained through jnan vidhi in akram vignan, if you end up getting angry and then ask for forgiveness, then there is no problem. You have become free. And if you cannot ask for forgiveness in person, then ask from within. Then it is done.
Yes, if we cannot ask for forgiveness in person, and if we ask for forgiveness from within, even then, it'll be cleared off.
Questioner, in person, in front of everyone? Dadashi, there is no problem if one does not ask for forgiveness in this way and simply does it from within. Even that will do. This is because this fault is not living, it is a discharge fault. Discharge fault means that it is not a living fault. Therefore, it does not give a tremendously bad result.
So this matter is after one takes Gnan. If there's any Mahatma, and if such a thing happens through him, then we can say it's discharge. You've become a pure soul. The fault is done by file number one, so make file number one do pratikarma for that. It's not a living fault. Living fault means it gets charged. On one side, it gets discharged, and on the other side, he feels, I'm indeed doing it. And what's wrong with that? That's referred to as a living fault. We don't have that. If some weakness remains in the non-living fault, then a huge punishment will not come for that. Read on.
Heading, anger, pride, deceit, greed remain in existence due to the installation of life in them. You are not the one who is running all of this. Anger, pride, deceit, greed, these kashayas are running it. The rain is indeed of these kashayas. It is when one has the realization of who am I that the kashayas leave. If one feels repentance when he ends up getting angry, but if he does not know how to do pratikaman, as shown by the Lord, then of what use is that? If one knows how to do pratikaman, then he will be able to become free.
In the worldly life interactions, we have to rush to our jobs, take care of the wife, and bring up the children. In reality, the self is not doing all of this. It's this ego, it's this minus. All of these worldly interactions run through this anger, pride, deceit, and greed. It's indeed the kashayas which are running the show. The kashayas are the ones ruling everything. If he goes to buy something in a shop, and if he looks for deals on things, then we should understand that greed is at work here. If he makes an impression, then pride is working there. If he tries to look good in front of others, then pride is at work there. If one enjoys something, then illusory attachment is working there. Therefore, these kashayas are certainly the ones that make us do the worldly interactions like this. Moreover, in the worldly interactions of kashayas, if the greed is nourished, then there's no problem. However, if there is any difficulty in nourishing the greed, then one does deceit. As long as the pride is nourished, then there's no problem. Whereas, if there's any difficulty nourishing the pride, then one gets angry. Therefore, in anger, pride, deceit, and greed, this anger and deceit keep getting used for the protection of pride and greed. The anger, pride, deceit, greed, all four of these are such that they cause misery to one's own self, and if they are in a big proportion, then they will give misery to others as well. That's referred to as aggression towards other living beings through thoughts, speech, or actions, or atikraman. We should definitely do pratikraman for the atikraman. If we do pratikraman, then the faults will keep decreasing. Jagriti, or the awakened awareness, means if I realize that I got angry, then it's referred to as jagriti. Jagriti is considered a result that is free from kashai. Only then will it keep decreasing. Read on. This is a very big discovery of Dada's. From where did the anger, pride, deceit, greed arise? If the worldly interactions is done through kashayas, then what is the main reason behind that? This is an amazing discovery by Dada.
Therefore, for how long does the proliferation of anger, pride, deceit, greed remain? It'll remain for as long as the conviction that I am Chandubai and this is indeed the way I am exists. As long as you have made the installation that I am Chandubai, people have instilled that in you, and you have come to believe I am Chandubai. Until then, this anger, pride, deceit, greed remain within.
So the anger, pride, deceit, greed. When one believes I'm Chandubai, we didn't believe it ourselves when we were born. People said, you're Chandubai. Therefore, we believed I'm Chandubai. People have instilled it in us and we have believed it. Then we believe I'm Chandubai and I'm correct. If someone says you're wrong, then immediately we feel suffering within. We feel insulted. If someone says you're very nice, then we feel respected. The pride is nourished. If someone says, you're beautiful. then your mind goes crazy. People have nursed the ego by doing installation. Whereas Dada says, the Gnani says, you are a pure soul and your Prakriti is separate. You're a pure soul, you're a pure soul. We want to do the same with children. The parents should understand in their minds that this is a file, and by the real viewpoint, the child is a pure soul. We should not miss out on this. Then the negative feelings of, he lies a lot, he's very obstinate, he's very mischievous, he doesn't listen to anything at all, he does mischief in the house all the time and damages things. All of these inner intents get instilled in the child and they keep deforming the Prakriti. We should say, he's playing. He's a pure soul. His filled stock of karma is getting emptied. He's very nice. We should tell him, my dear, it's good not to hurt others, right? We should keep speaking positively with him. We should have positive intents. We should keep seeing the positives in the child. And in the real, we should see him as a pure soul. Then the child will change completely. Here in this satsang, people see the pure soul in children. Nobody sees their mischief. So their moral values improve automatically. The entire world has arisen through the installation of life through intents. Recently in Simandar City, we had this discussion about prying. Your children don't come here? They don't believe in Dada? What about your husband? He doesn't allow you to come here? Why has he not come? If he has not come, then he's not come. Why do you have to talk like that? People pry so much. Why has he not come? People think they must have some problem amongst themselves. They don't get along with each other. The other person will say, everything is fine between both of us. People will ask, then why didn't he come? What do you have to do with whether he comes or not? People keep speaking pointlessly. This falls under negative installation through intent. If her husband has not come, then she feels, have I made a mistake? If my husband has not come, is that wrong? Everyone's husband is coming. If my husband has not come, then have I done something wrong? She starts suffering within. Whereas some people get affected even if people ask them casually. Therefore, it's surely the filled stock of the Prakriti. However, we don't want to get affected by it. We want to become free from the effect. We get affected by it. Why did this happen? People made such comments twice. Have I made a mistake? There's no mistake. People say things. People say, today the weather is very nice. It's a very sunny day. They become very happy. This is because what can they talk about? They don't have anything else to say. Therefore, when they try to talk, we get affected by it. And the one who's speaking doesn't realize that when I speak, the other person gets affected like this. Therefore, the worldly life is such. It affects one another. We should remain awake and alert. Dada says, one becomes the form that he envisions. People say, hey, don't you take care of your children? The other person will feel, what? Did I make a mistake? She'll feel, I'm a mother and I made a mistake. Therefore, one starts becoming the form that one envisions. It'll start affecting her, then she becomes the same form as the effect. We want to remain in Gnan. If someone says, didn't you do this? Then we should tell our file one, see, what's he telling you? I'm a pure soul. We should remain in this. And then speak. Do the worldly interactions as a neighbor. Then it won't affect you. If it doesn't affect us, then we don't become that form. We can remain in the form as the self. However, the installation through intent, this anger, pride, deceit, greed, if one believes I am Chandubai, then the entire universe of Kashais arises. Whereas if we remain in the Jagruti of I am pure soul, then all Kashais will dissolve. What happens in this Akram path? We come in the Jagriti of, I am a pure soul. Now this filled stock of karma prevails in the form of a result due to the installation done in the past life. We should settle it. We should keep it separate. If someone says, did you do this? At that time, we feel suffering within. The other person will ask, I'd kept this thing here. Did you take it? Where did it go? We reply, how do I know? The other person will say, it's just the two of us here, so where did it go? We reply, how do I know? This is because the chit was so absent that he may have moved things from here to there in a hurry. He may have kept the thing in the bag itself. And he'll tell us, I took the thing out from the bag and kept it on the table. So where did it go? We'll say, am I a thief? Do you think I want to take something that belongs to you? What will I do with your thing? Now he may have forgotten it himself and kept it inside. However, if someone asks twice, then we become upset and say, do you doubt me? Are you blaming me? Hey, nobody's doubting you or blaming you. However, it affects one another. This is where we need to keep Jagriti. The discharge result, we should reply calmly by remaining as the self. What are you trying to say? The thing must be here somewhere. I don't know about it. I haven't touched it. Check in your bag. He'll say, I had taken it out from the bag. We should say, just check. We should reply with discreetness and with steadiness within. I am a pure soul, and something has come on file one. I am separate. We should keep such steadiness and settle the worldly interactions. Therefore, our real spiritual effort is to keep such jagriti. We should not miss out on this. We should not get affected by it. Jai Sachidanand.